Hi children, welcome to grade 4 English and this is our first session in chapter 6, The Origin of Fire. Are you all excited? Yeah. And let's start our session with an energizer. Children, you all have to do an imaginary action as if you are shooting stones with a catapult. Are you all ready? Yeah. Ready? Shoot! Very good children, all of you did very well. And now we are moving on to our chapter number 6, The Origin of Fire. And now we are going to learn some new words. In your concept book, page number 85, fireflies, a fly that glows in the dark. Catapult, tool used to shoot stones from. Flickering, small quick movements of light. Imitate, copy or follow. Persuade, to convince or prompt. Juniper, a shrub with berry-like cones. Cedar, a cone-bearing tree which gives fragrant wood. Vigorously, using physical strength. Pursue, the action of chasing someone or something. Scattering, to spread a small amount of something in different directions. Ignited, caught fire. Okay, children, are you all clear about all these new words? You practice by making sentences in your note. Okay? Yeah, now we are moving on to did you know. Humans started using fire to cook food around 1 million years ago. And fire is also very useful to humans in many different ways, right? For light, heat and much more. And children should not play with fire as it can burn the skin. Children, you should never play with fire, right? Because it's very dangerous and it can burn the skin. And what is the lesson we are going to learn from this story, The Origin of Fire? It's good to be clever, but we should use our wits for the benefits of others. If we are clever or intelligent, we have to use it in a good way. Okay, we should always use our intelligence for benefiting others, for the benefits of others. We should not use it in the bad way. And this is what we are going to learn from this story. And now let's start reading the story. Yes, in your concept book, page number 87, The Origin of Fire. Children, let me summarize the story. Long, long ago, there was no fire at all. And Billy Fox, who lived in the forest, was the cleverest. And he tried to think of a way to create fire for the world. One day, he decided to visit the geese. He always wanted to imitate the cry of geese. The geese promised to teach him on one condition. If he would fly with them only, they can able to teach their cry. So they found a way. They attached the wings to the fox and also warned him that never open your eyes while you are flying. And children, in this picture you can see the geese and the Willy Fox, and they were flying together. And whenever the geese arose in flight, the fox also would join with them, okay, to practice their cry. On one such adventure, something strange happened. Darkness descended suddenly as they flew over the village of the fireflies. In the mid-flight, the light from the flickering fireflies in that village caused the fox to forget the warning. And what happened? He opened his eyes. Instantly, his wings started collapsing and his fall was uncontrollable. He landed inside the walled area of the firefly village. And there, a fire constantly burned in the center of the firefly village. And two kind fireflies came to see the fallen fox. The fox gave each one of the firefly the necklace of juniper berries. The fox managed to persuade the two fireflies and asked how he could find a way over the wall to the outside world. And they led him to the cedar tree. And they explained the tree would bend down upon command and will catapult you over the wall. And if he so desired, if he wanted to go outside of their village, you can use this like that, the fireflies told the fox. That evening, the fox found the spring. The fox found the spring where the fireflies got their water from. And there he also discovered colored earth, which when mixed with water made paint, and also discovered how to make paint with the help of the water. Upon returning to the village, the fox suggested to the fireflies that let's have a festival and we can dance and have fun and I will produce the music. And they all agreed. And they thought that it would be fun, and also they helped to collect the wood to build up a greater fire. Secretly, the fox made a plan. The fox tied a piece of cedar bark to his tail. Then he made a drum. And it was the first drum ever constructed by the Willy Fox. And beat it vigorously with a stick for the dancing fireflies. Gradually, he moved closer and closer to the fire. And children, you can see the happy Willy Fox playing drums and the fireflies, they were dancing happily. And also we can see the greater fire at the center of the village. And the fox pretended to be tired from beating the drum. And he gave it to some fireflies who wanted to help him to create the music. The fox quickly thrust his tail into the fire and lightening the bark. He tried to lightening the bark by moving close to the fire. And after that, he exclaimed, "It's too warm here for me. I must find a cooler place." Like that he told, and he ran away straight to the cedar tree. And calling, "Bend down to me, my cedar tree, bend down." And after hearing this command, the cedar tree bent down for the fox to catch hold. Then up it carried him far over the wall. Okay, it threw him far over the wall. On and on he ran with the fireflies in pursuit. Okay, he ran very fast and the fireflies started chasing. As the fox ran along bushes and wood on either side of his path, they all were ignited from the sparks dropping from the burning bark tied to its tail. The fox was finally tired and gave the burning bark to the hawk, and it carried to the brown crane. He flew far southwards, scattering fire sparks everywhere all around the world. The fireflies continued chasing the fox all the way to his burrow and declared, "Forever after, Willy Fox, your punishment for stealing our fire will be that you can never make use of it for yourself." And they cast a spell on this Willy Fox and told him that you cannot able to use the fire you stole from us for yourself. Okay, and the story is really very interesting, right? Yeah, and it is an American folk tale. And what is the moral of the story, children? Being generous makes us happy. If you are generous, it always makes us happy and it gives joy and satisfaction to those who benefit from our acts of generosity. And being generous not only gives us happiness, but also the person who got benefited from your generosity, they can also be very happy and satisfied. Clear? And children, let me tell you the home assignment for today's session. Read chapter 6, The Origin of Fire story in your concept book, page number 87, 88 and 89 thoroughly, children. Read the story thoroughly twice or thrice, and after completing that, you have to complete practice zone 1. And first question, who was Willy Fox and what did he think of doing? Second one, who did he decide to visit and what did he want to imitate? Third one, how did the fox fly with the geese and why? Fourth, what did the geese tell the fox not to do? Fifth, how and where did the fox fall? Who came to see the fallen fox? And sixth one, what did the fox persuade the fireflies to tell him? Seventh one, what did the fox do with the burning bark of wood? And eighth question, whom did the fox give the burning bark to and how did the fire spark scatter everywhere? Okay, children, it's very easy. Read the story thoroughly. Be clear with the story. Then you can complete this practice zone 1 questions. Clear, children? Yes. And after completing your homework, hand in it in grade 4 English Google Classroom. Children, drink more water, eat healthy food, reduce your screen time, give adequate rest to your eyes, don't use mobile phones and television often, stay home and stay safe, children. Thank you so much.